This next contest is scheduled.
We're back with more WWF action, and I'm for one looking forward to the matchup with the Bushwhackers and the Beverly Brothers, considering on the fact you got Genius in the corner of the Beverlys, and of course in the corner of the Bushwhackers, who?
Jameson.
Uh-oh. And his opponent, being accompanied to the ring by his manager, Paul Bearer, from Death Valley, weighing 328 pounds, the Undertaker.
And there's the man, ladies and gentlemen, former World Wrestling Federation champion, a man who unquestionably has come closer than anyone else in history to literally, as well as figuratively, burying Hulkamania.
And all the little Hulksters that follow him around as well.
The Undertaker, one of the 30 participants in the Royal Rumble. The Undertaker, along with a Hulkster, along with the Macho Man, IRS, Virgil, Ric Flair, the British Bulldog, the Warlord, Texas Tornado, the Berserker, Jake the Snake, the Matador, both Nasty Boys, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Rowdy Roddy Piper, and more to be named. They all are entering the 30-man Royal Rumble for the undisputed World Wrestling Federation Championship.
I can't wait till Ric Flair sweeps the Royal Rumble.
And you might wonder what the Undertaker, for that matter, Paul Bearer, would like to have for Christmas.
Mm. A big, big box.
Big pine box, no doubt. Mm. Look at that puss, would you? My goodness, what a kisser on Paul Bearer. I would like to peer across the room and look into a face like the Undertaker.
I certainly would not like that.
Meet him in a dark alley. Meet him in the squared circle. Meet him in the Royal Rumble. Who wants to meet this guy?
Not Hulk Hogan, that's for sure.
I don't think anyone really does. Unbelievable credentials. An incredible athlete. But a most strange individual. We spoke to him earlier on. Here's what he had to say along with Paul Bearer.
There's absolutely no doubt in my mind, after the Royal Rumble, the WWF title will be back around my Undertaker.
More important than the title will be the 29 souls that we possess.
Look at the color of this guy's face. What do you think? Is this something to do with his diet?
I don't know, but Doc, you can tell he doesn't spend too much time out in the sun, that's for sure.
Dark places, dark, cold places.
Undertaker, pretty much having his way with Al Phillips. What is in the urn, Mr. Parker?
Well, McMahon, not that it's any of your business or anything else, but I think he's got a full of candy canes for the Christmas season.
No, I don't think so. I don't think so. I think if you popped the top on that sucker, I bet it would stink up. There's no telling what he has in there.
You think if he buries Hulkamania once and for all, they'll need a bigger urn?
I'd rather not comment. Undertaker stalking his prey, Al Phillips. Phillips now going up. Ooh, firewood a suplex. When he takes you up, you go way up. And when he takes you down, you go way down. About 6 feet down. Undertaker very methodically stalking his opponent. Perhaps the most methodical wrestler in the history of the WWF. Look at this.
This really amazes me. Being Mr. Perfect, a man who knows all the moves. This takes a lot of talent. This is a phenomenal athlete.
Down across the back.
Oh, yes!
Oh, my. Paul Bearer. Strange, strange combination. Paul Bearer and The Undertaker. Undertaker, uh-oh. Getting ready to plant another opponent. Getting ready to deliver the tombstone. Cinches him up. And down.
Oh,
shit. About that.
Oh,
goodness. It'll break your back, break your neck, whatever.
Bring out the bag.
Look at that look. You can bet all Al Phillips.
Oh, the
would want for Christmas is to survive the match with The Undertaker. I'm not so sure he did.
Well, he's getting a nice custom-made bag for Christmas. That's kind of nice.
Huh. How would you like to be in there? No one would want to be in there.
No, they wouldn't.
And the look of awe on the face of the youngsters about ringside, not exactly knowing what to make of The Undertaker, except that he's awesome. That much they know. Let's go back and take another look at it.
Take a good look at this. That's almost 7 feet down onto the back of your neck. Off the top rope with that agility. But this is the tombstone. Watch the neck.
Oh, my goodness.
Their neck is not made to bend that way. One, two, three. Zip them up.
And The Undertaker, once again, victorious. Perhaps victorious in the Royal Rumble as well. Speaking of whom, let's take you now, ladies and gentlemen, to comments from other World Wrestling Federation superstars participating in the 30-man Royal Rumble.